Charles Davis. As always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Evan McPherson has this one teed up, and off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
Down!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it's second down.
Here we go. Set.
He'll drop to throw. Oh, the man is Keyshawn Johnson. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary, all of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
So it's second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They haven't been able to stop them so far this series, but getting a nice little stand from their defense now.
Ready. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Back to throw again. He will find his man Chase complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass.
And if the peek behind the curtain, and he is into the end zone for a touchdown. DeMarco Murray punching it in from a yard away. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. Zerline good with a PAT. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Young guy, that.
11. They hand off to their big tight end. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Well, they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
On the ground, this is Joe Mixon. 7 yards there and a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handle it a little bit of power. And you find a way to pick up first downs.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he is going to lose yardage here. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
That's not an easy play for a defensive end because most. most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working, but how about his vision to see where the play was going? Crashed down inside and tackled him for a loss.
The throw over the middle, taken in. So the completion good for 7 there. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. They go back to the ground now with Mixon. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe. Tackle that time by Cindy Jones. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Again, it's Mixon. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Now Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. It's Mixon on the counter. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you. And sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. 4th down now after a loss of 2. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. So on 4th down, off goes Burrow. On comes Evan McPherson for the Bengal field goal. From the right hash, this from 45 yards away. McPherson's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So both teams come away with points on their opening drives. Now they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
Let's go. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. For this offense, Charles, remember the last time they were out here, marched it nearly the full length of the football field, and a lot of the attack went through the air, so now they're seeing if they can duplicate that performance.
Okay, if I show my age a little bit, partner, because I can hear my high school coach, John Ford. I can hear his voice in my head.
On the double.
Laddie, when you put the ball in the air, 3 things can happen, and 2 of them are bad. But the way the game's being played now, this is just part of what they do, so I don't think they should change anything at all. They've been dominant. Keep throwing it around.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield.
Yo, 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 you got this.
Wait, wait.
What? And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Patriots.
That's right. Money squad. Motherfucking money squad. 10, money squad.
And he's is into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a Patriot touchdown. And Charles, look at the big fumble.
Thank you for that motherfucker. Good luck right there, bro. Yeah, man, that was that boost I needed.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get in following that fumble return for a score. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high.
I got both my cornerbacks on acrobat right now.
Now second and 10. Now back to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
They have to like what they've done.
A couple
of incomplete passes bring up a third and 10.
Ready.
Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Ready.
Out of the gun now on third down. And that's incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed. Unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
They're going to try and...
Oh, yeah.
Crossing route catch made by Johnson. And he's trying to get his...
That should have been a fucking interception. That should have been a motherfucking interception, bro.
He needed five. He didn't get much more than that. But it's enough in a first down.
I'm wondering.
No, he mad. No, he fucking mad.
Now it's Mixon running right. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space.
No.
Looking to throw on second down. Burrow. This caught left side by the tight end Parham. And inside the 20 before he's brought
down. We take 3 points.
And we're going to get a timeout.
We'll take the 3 points.
With 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Put some points on the board. We'll take
a
three.
So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. A 33-yarder from the left hash. McPherson's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are
and I got the ball back. Hell
yeah. Number three alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. Taking it about the one. At the line, ready to go. Mixon will get it to start the second half. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Back to Mixon on second down. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Now it's Burrow. They're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. And they will be set up.
Fuck.
Now as he
I fucked up.
Threw it
to the wrong person.
That is a tough way to start the third quarter. You get the football open to drive it down, put it in the end zone, and take the lead. Instead, they give him the football.
And I think the key here is for them to not get discouraged. That is not how they drew it up, not how they saw it in their mind. But there's a long way to go in this game. You know, they've just got to find a way to come back one play at a time. Yes, it's a cliche, but they can get it done.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line.
On the set.
The Patriots going with a dime package and two extra defensive backs on third.
Red, yellow. Red.
Back to throw here. And it's caught. Touchdown. Donald Pearl from 13 yards out. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown. Zerline connects on the extra point. And that will put them on top here in the third. Now after the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. Taken at the goal line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. So the offense back out now, coming off its first interception of the game the last time out, trying to reestablish some momentum here, Charles. But they're trailing defense. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together.
Now Burrow loses the football. Fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Down. Here's Joe Burrow. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. but they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on, or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play, so we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Options galore here, second and a few inches. Mixon running wide side. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 48 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Mixon running wide side. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
On second down, here's Mixon.
What the fuck, bro? It was clear. It was wide the fuck
open. Wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
On third down, Burrow dumps it off to Mixon. And he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Here we go. It's Burrow on fourth down. Open man, Parham. He's got him. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Give him credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Mixing up the middle. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a nice pickup.
What's up, man?
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we got a one-score game. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. They come up on a first and goal with this game still hanging in the balance. First and goal, a touchdown and a two-point conversion here are musts. They'll give it to Mixon. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Joe Mixon, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots have a chance to tie things up as they trail by two here in the fourth. Throwing, Burrow, and he's gonna be sacked. They came after him, he couldn't get away, and this remains a two-point game. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, they can smell victory, partner. They can see it on the horizon, but certainly we're not done yet here. Defense still has three timeouts, and obviously this is a very slim lead they're holding on to.
Here we go. So the easiest way to get this done,
Challenger ground game. Challenger offensive line, your tight end, your receiver. Anyone who's going to lay down a block, don't let there be penetration, because they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and maybe bring extra people to the ball. If you can do that, make them burn their timeouts, run out the clock, life will be good. But if you really want to gamble a little bit, a quick play action, quick down. Throw, might be able to get it done. Just make sure it's not incomplete and stop the clock.
Triple 38.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline to talk over what to do next. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Throw over the middle into the hands of the tight end, Parham. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 39. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. His throw complete right side to the tight end Parham. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They're going to look to throw. And look at this. They get the throw. They need it. It's intercepted.
Let's fucking go. Let's fucking go.
Right back in this football game.
Let's fucking go.
At the line, ready to go. Burrow connecting with Mixon, and he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and that will bring up second down. Joe Mixon, and they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. To throw, Burrow.
Let's go! Game over! Game fucking over! Let's go! Let's go! Money squad! Game over! Game over! Game fucking over! Who here to see that shit? Who's on here to see this shit live? Who saw this shit? Who in my chat? Who in my motherfucking chat? Game over. Game over. Game. Game. Over. Over.
To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away.
You got three timeouts, though. You better try to do something with it.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25.
Here we go.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now,
ready.
And they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. One final shot. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete.
Game over. Game over. Game fucking over.
Game is over. Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide.
Motherfucking right. Game.
They were so
the fuck.
Up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Game over.
Like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded. Because
yeah, take your ass back there and cry. Before.
Couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end.
Yeah, game over. Get your ass out of here.
In this case, though,
game fucking over.
GFG.
That was a good fucking game. I think I'm gonna upload this game as a video to my YouTube channel. That was a good fucking game. Game fucking over. Let's look at some fucking highlights. Oh, they should play this shit by itself. How you play that shit?
I would.
Game fucking over. That should have been an interception. That was the last play. Where's the interception at where I had... Where's the interception I had? Damn, they need better instant replays like FIFA. That's where they fucking up with this game. Game fucking over. Let's look at some stats. Total offense, 227. We got more rushing yards than them. They got a little bit more passing yards. We got more first downs. Get some player stats. My quarterback had more completions. That was just a good fucking game, bro. That was a hell of a game, bro.